in the bottom lane.
Yeah, Tail's actually going to be discovered here. He's going to flash and Valkyrie. There's the knock-up, though. The Flay to come in as well as they're tanking up the turret beautifully. First blood going to Condi.
Members running up there to try and get in range to help Let Me Out, but they might be too late.
Yeah, Descent's going to land here. There's the teleport coming through from M3 at the same time. It's going to be a 4v1. Love City taking a lot of damage. He's going to flash out of the way as Let Me going to try and dance around this fight, but doesn't manage to, of course. Candy at level 6. No worries there at all. He has to flash out of the way of the turret shot as the Ride of the Arcane comes through, but of course not quite enough range to deal with it. And Dade just sort of misses his friends, wants to join in the party.
Yeah, so now he's around the back. He's looking to get involved, maybe get in on that ward. Wow, he goes in so deep.
Yeah, there's the Dark Binding immediately exhausted as well as Sync Dream's going down quite low. Let Me finally managing to get back in with that teleport. Looper in a little bit of trouble, but the Black Shield is beautiful. Oh, that Frozen Tomb to help Looper out, but Jahu might be able to finish off that kill. Let Me dies first though, and that's the miss of the skill. Jahu manages to pick up the kill in the end, but Shocking Orb going wide once more, flashing out of the way. Sync Dream has to be very careful. So much action across this map. The fifth kill for M3 goes down as Jahu misses yet another ability. Not quite his game thus far.
Get it just because of some good wards, and maybe even Garmty might have thought it went down earlier than what it did. However, won't be as early as they could have possibly done, but 5 seconds. I guess they'll take it.
Yep. Not too much of a big deal. Horses for courses potentially here, Spawn. But M3, they are going to transition here to the bottom side. Descent's not going to land, but Sync Dream, of course, with no flash, not going to do anything about this Cataclysm. He's going to fall down. Candy picks up his first kill as that Rat-a-tat-tat comes down, and almost unnecessarily there because there was nowhere for Sync Dream to go.
And that was some sick, nasty damage coming out of the Jarvan. He's 3-0-3, very inflated for this stage of the game, and has already finished off that armor penetration as they try and now dive Looper. He's got his ultimate. This is dangerous.
Yeah, this is going to be a big problem. Transcendent Blades comes through. Looper finally uses that ult. Let Me's going to die as Looper finally pays for it, but may actually pick up another one. No.
Oh,
the creeps.
Oh.
One last order. Oh, doesn't get him. He leveled. Strategic leveling.
He was so low, but throughout the river, Dade's also zoned off Jahu, so only trading kills there.
0-1. Candy's having a great time.
Yeah, it certainly is. Dade in the mid lane got caught. He's dead.
Yep. Yeah. Very dead.
Dude, we see the dragon started up. Corki wants to use it to lane, to poke, to be able to rotate around and take out turrets. Whereas Candy, he wants to find someone by himself when he has a teammate.
She just does grab, and is now the time where Corki needs to be moving and making plays here for Gamfi. Let Me, he's going to get caught out. There's the Transcendent Blades, but Sync Dream and Huey, they've come around here as well as Condi. He's going to get shut down. Looper now in a lot of trouble. Just glacial paths onto the Dark Passage and gets out. But if you look down the board here for Gamfi, is Sync Dream just going to Black Shield that one away? Ooh, Candy taking a lot of damage. There's Ride of the Arcane. His aim is on, and he lands it onto Candy. Beautiful play from Jahu, making up for that first skirmish.
Yeah.
You sort of hold on to that, I want to kill my lane opponent, throughout most of a game, as M3 now going to have to struggle here against the Dragon. It's going to fall down to Huey, but Sync Dream just gets popped very early on. Huey now in the backside, going to kick Candy out of the fight. Can't really rat-a-tat-tat onto any members. Huey eventually going to go down for it. It was some cute play, but the Dragon did go over to Gamfi, and that's their first one. That's important to pick up.
Yes, but it's fantastic for him, though.
Oh, Sync Dream, you're in so much trouble. The Rat-a-tat-tat come through. Dade actually in a lot of trouble as he takes his E in order to get himself to safety. The shield there as well from that face of the mountain. Dade solo. Whoa. Doesn't get knocked up. That was huge damage coming down as Let Me is trying to find Looper, who's going to fall down. Under the turret is a bad place for a Lissandra, and that was gigantic burst coming through from Gamfi.
Condi in the jungle.
Yeah, Let Me actually home guarding in, just equilibrium strikes. Struck? Equilibrium strikes him to death. That was a difficult one to say. And Phosphorus Bomb not going to find Ken.
Team fights up. Looper committing to the push for
Dade. Oh, that was a big ride there for Huey as the box comes through. He gets slowed down. Love City might just get focused, but Candy comes in the backside. Jahu now from a long way away. Looper's just going to die instantly. Couldn't even use the ultimate, and the rest of M3 have to run away. Ride of the Arcane hits one bolt, but Condi's going to survive that one. But oh, it's looking very dangerous. Dade going to get slowed down by that one, but Gamfi with a beautiful team fight so far. Oh, Dade actually going aggressive yet again. The Zhonya's is there, though, and Let Me just hanging out. He's happy just to tank this one up. Candy, he's the only member alive, and Gamty, they're team fighting pretty well in this mid game.
Yeah, the clean ace. The problem there was Lupe got stunned as soon as he flew into the team and was not able to get his ultimate off. Otherwise, that was a perfect fight for M3. No one would have been able to walk through all of the AoE Lupe was bringing with him.
Of course, checking out you standing up there, but since we've got back into the game, it's just looking ridiculous here for M3 because now they're just caught between these really bad decisions and the Baron, it's about to go down. Dade, that is a beautiful ultimate into the pit, but he's taking a lot of damage. Yahoo, exactly where he wants to be in this fight as well, as he's going to destroy Dade. Every member of M3 getting exploded, and there goes the Baron. Gamty looking so good. Just mean a definite inhibitor turret? It does. The inhibitor could go down as well, and Gamty in firm control in the 35 mark, and this is not when we thought they'd be the most powerful. We thought it'd be earlier. Mid lane, all they have to do is set up a siege here as well, and as long as Tail could use that Bloodthirster in order to get in, get some poke damage down, you can see M3 can't really do anything. That big one decimating. Lupa coming through for the flank, wants to try and get something to happen here, but he gets blown up yet again. Condi gonna fall down. Love CD in a lot of trouble now as Letmy is massive here on the front line, right of the arcane in here as well as Huey picks up Love CD. Dade and Candy, the only ones left alive. And with no frontline, what are they gonna do?
Nothing, and these super creeps are already on the Nexus turrets. They've nearly taken the bottom one out. Top one will soon to follow. And Gamty once again executing against the no tank lineup very well, but you have to question the decision making out of M3 through that mid game.